E1.
Senior British civil servants are expected to have talks with Sinn Féin representatives in Belfast tomorrow. Sinn Féin's Martin McGuinness will head his party's delegation. The discussions look set to begin at Stormont Castle at around noon. The talks will mark the resumption of the dialogue which ended after the breakdown of the IRA ceasefire last year. Meanwhile, the loyalist paramilitary group, the Ulster Freedom Fighters, has warned the British government that it must stick to the terms for Sinn Féin's entry into political talks. The Home Office in London has announced that two more long-term Republican prisoners in Britain are being sent back to Northern Ireland. A government spokesman confirmed that one of them is Danny McNamee from Crossmaglen in South Armagh, who's serving a 25-year jail term. The deputy leader of the SDLP, Seamus Mallon, has welcomed the announcement, as has Sinn Féin. It's understood both men are being moved to McGabbery Prison near Lisburn in County Antrim. Garda reinforcements have been called into Longford town following a disturbance at a traveller's halting site. Two men were injured, one of them is being treated in hospital. The situation is reported to be calm. In the general election campaign, both the Taoiseach and the Thornister have stressed the closeness of the Rainbow parties on tax policy. The two leaders were speaking in the Taoiseach's home village of Dunboyne in County Meath, where Mr Bruton said the three parties wanted to help low and middle income earners. The Fianna Fáil leader Bertie Ahern has said he's not going to get into auction politics on the issue of taxation during the election. Speaking in Nina, he said he was not going to move any further on tax and that their tax document was a realistic one. Earlier today, the Thornister launched the Labour Party manifesto with emphasis on tax reduction and job creation. Mr Spring said that in choosing the next administration, people will want proof that promises will be delivered on. And finally, the Progressive Democrats have promised to increase contributory state pensions to £100 a week over 5 years if elected to government. Canvassing in Cork, the party leader Mary Harney said the increase would be funded by the economic boom, and she warned that PDs would penalise unemployed people refusing what she called reasonable offers of work or training. Now a look at the weather forecast. Showery outbreaks of rain in western areas will die out, dry elsewhere apart from isolated showers at first, a mild humid night with lowest temperatures of 9 to 12 Celsius, some mist or fog patches also. Tomorrow will be dry in the south for much of the day with warm sunshine. Cloudier conditions in the north with patches of light rain or drizzle will gradually spread to all parts with brighter and fresher weather developing in the north later. But that's all from the newsroom for now. A very good night.